The Body Snatcher is a 1945 horror film directed by Robert Wise, who you probably know from his more famous films The Day the Earth Stood Still, The Haunting, West Side Story, The Sound of Music, and Star Trek The Motion Picture. This film was produced by Val Lewton and RKO Pictures, and is based on the Robert Louis Stevenson story of the same name, inspired by the true crime Burke and Hare murders that occurred in Scotland in the 1800s. The story centers around a doctor named Toddy who is wanting to figure out a way to cure a paraplegic girl. In order to do this, he needs to obtain bodies to operate on to gain the knowledge that he needs. He secures the services of a cab driver and grave robber named John Gray, who begins murdering people and threatening to expose Toddy's secret. The script was written by Philip MacDonald and extensively changed by Val Lewton himself after Joseph Breen's office nixed much of the story due to the violations of, quote, indecency of using dead bodies and locations involving dead bodies, unquote. Lewton was notorious for being a very hands-on producer who insisted on never taking credit for his creative input, instead ensuring that all of the glory would go to the directors and writers who worked on his films. However, MacDonald and the Writers Guild insisted that Lewton do so for The Body Snatcher due to the extensive rewrites, one of which included incorporating Stevenson's original story into the third act. Lewton reluctantly did so, but got the last laugh when he used the pseudonym Carlos Keith instead of his real name. Robert Wise, who would go on to be known as one of the most versatile directors in Hollywood history, stated that he learned more about screenwriting and script structure from Lewton than anyone else in his career. Lewton was also the man that gave Wise his first directing opportunities, for which he was always eternally grateful. Wise's favorite memory of Lewton, and the example he would often give in interviews to show what kind of man he was at his core, was when he got behind schedule while filming The Body Snatcher. Lewton would watch rushes, more commonly known as dailies, in the afternoons with the RKO studio heads, who instructed Lewton to warn Wise that he could be removed from the film if he could not get back on schedule. In fact, this is how Wise got his first directing gig, when he replaced Gunther von Fritsch on Lewton's Curse of the Cat People because he had fallen well behind schedule. Lewton showed up, relayed the message to Wise, and then basically told him, "Screw him. Your stuff looks great, keep doing what you're doing, let me worry about the suits." The Body Snatcher is the last cinematic pairing of Boris Karloff and Bela Lugosi, two icons of the horror genre's heyday from the 1930s. Karloff was particularly keen to play this role, feeling that this was his best chance to be seen as a bona fide actor and not just someone in monster makeup. Henry Danielle, who plays Toddy, was considered one of the best English character actors of the time period, and Karloff relished the opportunity to go toe-to-toe with him.
Look here, Gray. I fitted them together like this. So that it was right. Yet she won't walk.
You can't build life the way you put blocks together, Toddy.
What the devil are you talking about? I'm an anatomist. I know the body, I know how it works.
You're a fool, Toddy, and no doctor. It's only the dead ones you know.
I am a doctor, I teach medicine.
Like Knox taught you, like I taught you? In cellars and graveyards? Did Knox teach you what makes the blood flow?
The heart pumps it.
Did he tell you how thoughts come and how they go and why things are remembered and forgot?
The nerve centers the brain.
What makes a thought start?
The brain, I tell you, I know.
You don't know, and you'll never know or understand, Toddy. Not from Knox or me would you learn those things.
Lewton had initially been hesitant to cast Karloff because he did not believe in stunt casting, preferring to make high-quality B-movies that felt realistic, and he was concerned that casting Karloff would hurt what he was doing creatively. That was until Jack Gross, an executive at RKO that Lewton deeply disliked, pressured him into meeting the famous horror icon. Karloff and Lewton hit it off, which is how Isle of the Dead and The Body Snatcher came into being. After production on Isle of the Dead stopped due to Karloff having to be treated for extreme back pain issues, Lewton spun The Body Snatcher into production. Lewton was actually able to get more money for this film than usual on his productions because of the recent success of Universal's The Wolfman. A 1944 memo by Lewton gave the following reasons as to why this would be a good movie for Karloff. Number 1, title seems good. Number 2, exploitation value and a classic famous story. Number 3, 90% chance it was in the public domain. Number 4, characters are colorful, costumes available, sets are limited, and the setting is interesting. And number 5, also an excellent part for Bela Lugosi. Now, Jack Gross had also pressured Lewton into casting Bela Lugosi, believing that the film would make way more money if they could market both Dracula and Frankenstein's monster in the same film, which Universal had done to great success in the 1930s. Incidentally, Lugosi had originally turned down the role of Frankenstein's monster, allowing Karloff to take over the role. Lugosi's thick accent limited his ability to get significant roles, and Lewton was again hesitant but decided to write Lugosi's part himself. By this time, Lugosi had become deeply addicted to morphine, which was prescribed to him for severe stomach ulcers, and he was very frail on set. Weiss has stated that Karloff was one of the sweetest, gentlest men he had ever met, and noted that he was deeply understanding of Lugosi's health at the time due to his own back pain issues, and really nursed him through their scenes together, including the death sequence. Weiss stated that even though the crew could tell Karloff was in severe pain, he never once complained and was ultimately able to finish Isle of the Dead after shooting the Body Snatcher. Karloff had nothing but amazing things to say about Val Lewton and immediately signed a new three-picture deal with him, noting in interviews that Lewton was, quote, the man who rescued me from the living dead and restored my soul, unquote. Val Lewton was famous, even during his heyday, for making A pictures on B budgets, reusing sets and costumes, and finding the best actors that he could get. The Body Snatcher shot on the exterior sets, streets, and alleys of the Hunchback of Notre Dame. The interiors were shot on Soundstage 4 at RKO using recycled sets from other films. The staircase, for example, is from Orson Welles' The Magnificent Ambersons. Weiss stated that the famous street singer scene was conceived by Lewton himself, who firmly believed that what people imagined in their head was scarier than what could be shown on screen. He also utilized this theory to get around the Hays Code.
That's the gift of all to me. Silk and gold and all.
Weiss stated that his famous film The Haunting was made as a tribute to Val Lewton and shot in his style. The horse head sequence is another tribute to Lewton. Who created the first jump scare in Cat People. Contemporary reviews of The Body Snatcher were great, and it ended up on multiple year-end critics awards lists. It set multiple box office records in theaters that it opened in. However, it was given a Class B rating by the Catholic Legion of Decency for, quote, excessive gruesomeness, unquote, which hindered its ability to play in many jurisdictions. The film was cut up in one southern locale, the entire end with Karloff and the buggy cut out, causing it to make no sense at all. The Body Snatcher is fantastic, and if you haven't had the pleasure of seeing it, put it on your to-do list. Boris Karloff is incredible and brings a real menace and terror to the screen. Weiss's direction is on point, and the film has a very cool ending that predates the explosion of what I like to call comeuppance horror that would be popularized in the 1950s by companies like EC Comics with Tales from the Crypt. Thanks for listening to another installment of Forgotten Horrors. Next time, we're diving into the wild and crazy world of 80s shot-on-video horror with a look at John McBride's gore flick, Cannibal Campout.